We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In the ceremony today, we will witness the joining of Jeremy Michael Banachowski and Emily Elizabeth Hess in marriage. Who gives this woman to be married today? Today we have come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, that's up to you, fell in love, and are finalizing with their wedding today. I have been witness to this relationship from the start, and I can't tell you how honored I am to be here today helping. I've known Jeremy since the day he was born and Emily since the time that they started dating, which seems to be like ages ago. In reality, I've had the chance to watch them both grow into the adults that stand before us today. From high school at Shaler to college at Slippery Rock, and one year that Jeremy went to Edinburgh thinking he could endure the separation, but he couldn't. And on to their careers, they've grown individually and they've grown together as a couple. Anyone would be proud to call them their son or daughter. I know I certainly would. Today, Kim, Connie, and Jeff each gain a new son or a new daughter. Also on this beautiful day, surrounded by all your family and friends, we can't help but think of those family and friends that are watching this special day from heaven. There are three that most especially come to my mind: Jeremy's godfather, Ken, his grandfather, Pap, and of course, Emily's dad. Although he's not here, speaking as a father, I can very comfortably say that your dad would be so proud of who you've become and would love the man that you chose. One of my favorite stories of Jer and Em occurred when Jared was a senior in high school and Emily was a freshman at Slippery Rock. For those that don't know me, I work for the Lifelight program here in Pittsburgh, and one of our prevention programs we do is to participate in mock accidents at high schools. So how is this part of a wedding story you're telling me? So every year we do this at Shaler High School. When Jeremy was a senior, I arranged for him, I took him out to our base, and he flew in the helicopter into the accident scene that day. We went through the business we had to do. Emily was there to watch. Jeremy arrived by helicopter. They're sitting in the grass after the program had ended. And this rather large, very imposing police officer from Shaler Township, by the name of Carl Funtal, approached. And it was immediately apparent that Emily knew him. She got up, shook his hand, gave him a warm hug and a nice smile. They chatted for a little bit. She turned and said, "Carl, I want you to meet my boyfriend, Jeremy." Carl, not to miss a moment, grabbed Jeremy's hand, shook it, let him know in no uncertain terms that he was very concerned about Emily and Jeremy should be as well. He didn't say "or else," but believe me, it was implied. Jeremy replied with a very nervous laugh, similar to what he just did, and assured the officer that he would. Why was Carl so concerned? Well, he joined the Shaler Police Department around the same time that Emily's dad had, and I'm always told he made sure that Emily, Mike, and Katie were okay given the opportunity. That's how it is when your dad was a cop. I don't know the exact moment that I knew that we'd end up here today, but it's frankly hard to remember the days before they were together. It just seems right, though, doesn't it? They even have a celebrity name, which is Germily, in case you didn't know. I've teased them both many times over the years about who's in charge, the boss of their relationship. Who I chose and the percentage I chose was based solely on whatever the argument benefited me at the moment. Most often it would be Emily at 90% or 80%. But the fact is that despite the teasing, together they equal 100%, and I can't imagine them not together. Romance is fun, but true love is something far more, and it is their desire to love each other for life, and that is what we're here celebrating today. A good marriage must be created. The little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands, is remembering to say, "I love you," at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It is speaking words of appreciation, then demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right person, it is being the right partner. And now we have two readings, please, from first Emily's Aunt Karen and then Jeremy's Aunt Missy.
Why marriage? Because to the depths of me, I long to love one person with all my heart, my soul, my mind, my body. Because I need a forever friend to trust with the intimacies of me, who won't hold them against me, who loves me when I'm unlikable, who sees the small child in me, and who looks for the divine potential of me. Because I need to cuddle in the warmth of the night with someone who thanks God for me, with someone I feel blessed to hold. Because marriage means opportunity to grow in love, in friendship. Because marriage is a discipline to be added to a list of achievements. Because marriages do not fail, people fail when they enter into marriage expecting one another to make them whole. Because knowing this, I promise myself to take full responsibility for my spiritual, mental, and physical wholeness. I create me. I take half of the responsibility for my marriage. Together, we create our marriage. Because of this understanding, the possibilities are limitless.
A reading from the Corinthians. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails, but where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, but when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror, then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Jeremy and Emily have written their own vows, and we'll recite them to each other now. Jeremy will go first.
I can't believe that the day is finally here. The last 7.5 years have been by far the best that I've ever had. I mean, look at how far we've come. We started in high school with you making fun of me all the time. And then here we are all these years later, and you're still making fun of me all the time. You're the funniest, most caring, kind person that I know, and you encourage me to be the best part of myself that I can be. And you not only like, but appreciate and encourage me to be as weird as I possibly can. And I will always appreciate that. You don't understand how much. I promise you that I'm always going to strive to be the best person that I can be, even when it's tough. Chuckles. I promise to work on the little things, like yelling at Xbox, as much as the big things. I promise to not hold it against you when you turn all the lights on at 5:30 in the morning and wake me up when I'm trying to sleep. I promise you an endless supply of your favorite thing, forehead kisses. I promise to be your partner in crime when you've had a couple drinks and want to steal all of the glasses from the bar. Your comedian when you need a good laugh. Your shoulder to cry on when you've had a bad day. The chicken to your duck. And most importantly, your best friend. I promise all of this from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poor, through Penn Stanley Cup championships and early playoff exits, till death do us part. I love you.
I haven't talked yet, so I don't know if the mic can hear me. Jeremy, I adore everything about you. I am so lucky to have someone who supports me in absolutely everything I do, no questions asked. I love that you are just as silly as I am, even though most people wouldn't guess that. I love the way you get excited over and appreciate the smallest things. In all seriousness though, the past 7.5 years have been more amazing than I could have ever imagined. And that is all because I met you. And here we are, ready to start the rest of our lives together. A day that I have been ready for the longest time. So when I pinched your butt the other day, it was because I was preparing for the vows I'm about to say as we begin our forever. I vow to never pinch your butt when you are walking up the steps in front of me. I promise to love you, even when you are yelling at your Xbox. I vow to mix the cream cheese for the buffalo chicken dip when you can't deal. I promise to be weird and childish and maybe even annoying, but only because you are my forever. And you are the only person I want to annoy for the rest of my life. I promise to laugh with you through good times and to comfort you through the bad. I vow to be your home away from home, just like your arms are my home. I can't promise to fix all of your problems, but I do promise that you won't have to face them alone, because if you're a duck, then I'm a duck. I promise to never forget how we feel about each other on this day. I promise to love you always. I vow to not only be your wife, but your best friend, your other half, your ear when you need someone to listen, your sidekick, your number one supporter, your soulmate. I vow to be your forever.
Jeremy and Emily, I would ask that you always treat yourself and each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority to tenderness, gentleness, and kindness your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do to every relationship, ask my wife, at one time or another, focus on what still seems right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. This way, when clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives and you lose sight of it for a moment, you can remember what the sun is still there. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and happiness. Jeremy, do you take Emily to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding on to her forevermore?
I do.
Emily, do you take Jeremy to be your husband?
Do
you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding on, let me try that again, holding only unto him forevermore?
I do.
Josh, give me the rings, please. The ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. And no giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows you have taken today. Repeat after me. Putting the ring on, please. I, Jeremy, take you, Emily, to be my wife.
I, Jeremy, take you, Emily, to be my wife.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and sorrow.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
And with this ring, I take you as my wife.
And with this ring, I take you as my wife.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I, Emily, take you, Jeremy, to be my husband.
I, Emily, take you, Jeremy, to be my husband.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
To have and to hold in sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and sorrow.
For richer or for poorer, in joy and in sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
And with this ring, I take you as my husband.
And with this ring, I take you as my husband.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
To make your relationship work will take love. That is the core of your marriage and why you are here today. It will take trust to know that in your hearts, you truly want what is best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and grow together. It will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you both have pledged to today. By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. I'd like to introduce the new Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Banachowski.
From his old pipe, laughed and said, all I can say is, don't blink, just like that, you're 6 years old, and you take your face and fade in life. Oh, we'll bound to get together, she took my arm. Don't you dare look back, just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding me.
Ooh. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Just a little bit of. Cadillac, Cadillac, pop that trunk. Let's take a shot, Ali, you that don't. Tired of
with that rhyme hardcore. Or maybe cause she heard that I bought out the store. Bottom of the ninth in the city, got the score. If not, I gotta move on to the next floor. Here comes the three to the two to the one. Homeboy tripping, he don't know I got the gun. When it come to popping, we do this for fun. You ain't got one stick and you better run. Now I'm in the back getting eaten from my huns. While she going down, I'm bragging on what I done. She smoking my stuff, saying she ain't having fun.
So let's play, yeah. I'm taking the game, the game's mine. Yeah, I witness the change, it's my time. Yeah, I'm new to the game, but y'all might wanna say your whack raps, daylight saving time. I can dance, homie, I don't two-step. Y'all looking at something like a true player. A girl told me that a man that could dance might could possibly get down with the tool in his pan. Now I'ma ladies, let me see it vibrate. And when it's over, you ain't gonna need your bow. Cause I'm a pro, make you bend your back low, then the pound it real bad, just like the percolator.
Wobble, baby, wobble.